These women pose a major threat to the 26-year rule of one man.
Страну они не получат.
Presidential elections in Belarus are usually very predictable. President Alexander Lukashenko has comfortably won all of them since the very first in 1994. But this year's election has proven to be very different, as mass detentions have galvanized the opposition and sparked widespread protests. And while the president has said he wants to hear the voice of the people, hundreds have been arrested throughout the campaign. Political novice Svetlana Tikhanovskaya is the wild card of this election. She is running in place of her husband, Sergei Tikhanovsky, a popular YouTuber who was arrested in May. He faces up to 12 years in prison on various charges, which rights groups say are politically motivated. Svetlana has called her candidacy a gesture of love towards her jailed husband. And her campaign has been endorsed by two key opposition figures who were also barred from running, Viktor Babarika and Valery Tsipkala. She has promised to free political prisoners and initiate a return to the Constitution of 1994, where reduced presidential powers and term limits were enforced. And if she wins, she says she will run fresh elections within 6 months.
Да, сначала мне было страшно. Я знаю, до какого дна может дойти власть, пытаясь сохранить свое кресло.
This photograph has become a key image of the election. It shows Svetlana with Tsipkala's wife Veronika and Babarika's campaign chief Maria Kolesnikova. But the president himself doesn't see a role for women at the top of government.
У нас конституция не под женщину.
Lukashenko is seeking re-election for the sixth time amid record low levels of support. In an official poll held by two independent media outlets, only 3% of voters saying they would back him. It quickly became a viral meme. There are three other candidates running for the top job. Lukashenko came to power in 1994 on a pro-Russian agenda and was at the heart of the Union State established between the two countries 5 years later. But he portrays himself as the protector of Belarusian independence from foreign interference, including from Moscow. The arrest of dozens of Russian nationals, whom Minsk described as mercenaries from the Russian private military company Wagner on terror charges, has been a bombshell in Belarus. Dramatic footage of the raids was shown on state TV. There are plenty of theories about what is really going on. Is it a Russian plot, a Belarusian one, or something cooked up between the two? But it is not the first time we have seen such stories ahead of an election. In 2006, Belarus's KGB reported an attempt to poison the Minsk water supply with a dead rat. There was no follow-up. And in 2017, state media reported the dramatic story of a jeep packed with armed men trying to break into Belarus from Ukraine, but eventually disappearing without trace between the two border checkpoints. Whatever the truth behind the most recent incident, it has brought issues of national security to the forefront of the conversation in the lead-up to the vote.